Well, Tua is one of the most accurate quarterbacks in the NFL, man. So,
I mean, obviously, you know, Tua, he's not your typical gunslinger, but, you know, like, if you really, like, just pay attention to his game, you know, everything is spot on, everything is pinpoint. You know, ball is on time. You know, his fundamentals are on point.
The NBA has most improved player. I think the NFL should have that. And if the NFL had that, Tua would be in line for that, don't you think?
Hey, go on, Tua. Come on now, Tua.
Well, Tua's just sitting down there with his ukulele in Miami. This is the first time he's been told that he's the starter. And Chris Long's like, well, nobody's going to be able to throw Tyreek Hill the ball down there.
Tua throws a deep 51 yards to the new weapon, Tyreek Hill.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah. Hey, welcome back to another Tua Tagovailoa content and the Miami Dolphins. I'm Ukule Elvis with my good buddy, the big European Tagovailoa supporter. Big Euro. Thank you very much. Hey, if you are listening for the first time, please make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to help us spread the love and the positive content that we are creating, not only for Tua Tagovailoa, but for the Miami Dolphins. Yeah, yeah, that's right. And also we also do another content for Tua's little brother, Taulia Tagovailoa, and then we do that one over at the other channel, the big European Tagovailoa YouTube channel. Yeah. So I'll put a link at the bottom so you can also go there and subscribe.
True. Very true.
And you know what? We had to erase twice. We've recorded a content. We had to erase it twice. Once we had a problem, but maybe the problem is fixed. But first time we erased everything was 30 minutes worth of content, it didn't work.
So I hope the problem is fixed. And another reason we also erased it was because we were doing the content and we had to redo everything because there was a press conference and, you know, there was Tua and McDaniels
So this is the third try. I hope this third try works.
It will work.
It will work. I believe it will work.
Oh, yeah.
You know, nothing like positive thinking. So for the title for this, we have Tua Tagovailoa haters are paying the price for their misinformation and denial as Dolphins versus Patriots arrive. Tagovailoa haters, price, denial. Hey, I love the title.
Thank you.
And you know what? Last time we were here, we had Stephen A. Smith do his bit here on Tyreek Hill and Tua Tagovailoa. And after listening to it twice, I thought we should listen to it again because something bothered me, you know?
It bothered me too. So where is it? I put it up.
But before, I need to explain myself because what happened was when we saw the clown when he was over at with Rich Eisen,
Michael
and
Lombardi,
doing his hating on Tua, and then Rich Eisen just smoothly just cut him off. And then we kind of put a break into that, you know, like... you know, put the brakes on that and just change the subject. And I think there's a place here where we actually can put the brakes on Stephen A. because it makes no sense. He's talking about Tua Tagovailoa, and all of a sudden he changes subject and do it on Tyreek. So obviously the hate was this whole idea of the captaincy for Stephen A. Smith was basically, it was about Tyreek. So let's hear it again.
This particular Miami Dolphins situation, Tua Tagovailoa being the captain is no big deal. And I'm going to tell you why. Because of Tyreek Hill.
You're right. Out of nowhere, he says to Tyreek Hill.
Well, basically, he came out just to hate Tyreek Hill. And it's not that. I mean, when you listen to him talking about Tyreek Hill, you think he's right, but he's actually wrong. Now, listen to this one here.
Tyreek Hill has diluted the importance of Tua Tagovailoa being a captain prior to the season. You know why? Because when Tyreek Hill got to Miami near South Beach, before he had an opportunity to pass gas, this brother was engaging in blasphemy by talking about Tua Tagovailoa was more accurate than Patrick Mahomes.
He was more accurate than Patrick Mahomes. Here it is. Put up the list.
here, look, accuracy percentage. Tua Tagovailoa, Miami Dolphins, 71.3%. Then it is Ryan Tannehill, Tennessee Titans.
That's right.
71.0%.
Yeah.
Joe Burrow is third.
Right.
Cincinnati Bengals.
Yes.
Accuracy, 69.3%.
That's right.
Justin Herbert, number four, Los Angeles Chargers. 68.4%.
Yeah.
And then Tom Brady, Tampa Bay Buccaneers, the GOAT, accuracy percentage, 67.7%.
So Tyreek Hill was right all along. And we should actually clap for Tyreek Hill for standing up for Tua. Because no one did, because they all lied. And you know what are the things that I found out, here was the things that we wanted to speak the truth, make sure that everybody hears it, is that there was a comment that stuck with me the whole time. And that comment was from this guy here,
right,
who said basically that if you lie enough times there on, people will hear you and they'll believe that it's true. But that's not his word. But let's play. Where is his word?
Let me find it. I put it up for you right now. Here it is.
And don't want to believe it, but if you hear something enough times, you gotta give it some credence. You gotta give it some credibility.
A lie is a lie is a lie is always a lie.
Misinformation, that is, you know? And, you know, misinformation is huge because here is what I'm talking about, this one. When we heard last time about him complaining, the clown complaining that there is a propaganda here of just speaking all nice things about Tua.
No one speaks nice things.
Which is not true.
No, not at all.
Because...
Not at all. And if they do speak nice things, they are angry.
But let's hear the what he's claiming was propaganda.
Michael?
Well, I think they're trying to convince themselves. I mean, you've never heard a better propaganda campaign about a player in preseason than you have about Tua. I mean, it's really every day he's been sensational. I mean, you know, and to me, you never had to hear a coach say Tom Brady was sensational. He just was.
Yeah. Well, let's hear this. So this is from last year when the season started last year. And the guy who's interviewing this hater was actually saying something nice about Tua. But it's like, you know, again, you hear the breaks and then they from the hater, you know, so that instead of continuing with the nice things, he just goes straight into like a misinformation on Tua.
This game, what's going to happen? What about on the other side of the football with Tua and the offense and the step it took forward for Miami when they start? When Tua, and it looks like Tua is better than he was a year ago. He seems better physically. They're saying he's throwing the ball better. He looks like he's more willing to push it down the field than he was a year ago. What does Miami's offense look like compared to where it was a year ago?
I would say that Miami's offense is very condensed. Tua is, to me, I don't think he's an overly talented thrower of the football. I think you have to understand what he is, and I think the previous coaching staff knew that, and I think this coaching staff is essentially finding out the same thing. He's a pure...
Thank you, Rich, for putting on the brakes. Basically, misinformation and all this hate is coming out, and, you know, that was last year. I mean, but that's not it. There's so many people. Here's another guy from IMF Meet.
Yes.
I mean, really... I mean, he works together with the other hater. I think they sat down in a circle.
Yes.
They sat in a circle and decided what hate to use.
What
you know, which
to
one
use?
To make Tua look
absolutely
so negative. So, here is what he said.
Yeah, let me put it up. I think he's a former Miami Dolphins player, but now he's with the X and O Sun Sentinel journalist. I don't know what he's doing now. Here they are, like, but this is not from I'm Athlete. He was on a different show with Max. But this is what he said. Exactly. This hate, I don't know where it comes from.
We'll see. Listen, the thing about Tua, Max, he's a slow blinker. Do you know what a slow blinker is?
Tell me.
A slow blinker is someone who can't process quickly. He gets back in the pocket too late. You know, he can't go from his first read to the second to the third. If Tua
Thank you, Rich. Yeah, man. Yeah, yeah. I mean, the hate is out there. There's tons and tons of hating from all this. That's why I put this up. Who will be next?
Yeah.
Who is not going to be? And who will be an ex-talking head on these old media platforms?
Yeah, it is true.
I mean, their denial of how talented Tua is compared to what they are putting out is incredible. So, you know, whoever the clown here is saying that there is propaganda to say good things about Tua Tagovailoa, I wonder why.
You know,
that's I mean, when we've heard now all this negative stuff, but there is tons more. But I'm always wondering, like, how do you plan to put all this negative stuff out on tour? Do you do you like get in a circle?
Yeah, yeah, that is right.
And then decide which word to pick.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, before they film the content or whatever, or whenever they have the meeting, person to person. But now they are zooming. But when you get together, you sit in a circle. You decide,
right.
Okay, who's doing what? And you know, so you call Jeremy in the middle of the circle, and you tell Jeremy to give you all his good stuff, because Jeremy, he's the guy who was saying, for example, for this group, you put Jeremy in and you tell Jeremy to give you all the good thing he's going to say about Tua.
Okay.
So when he says all the good things, then what are they doing then as a group when Jeremy is saying all the good things? Because, you know, you put Jeremy out there because he's the good-looking guy. You know, he can say all the good things about Tua, right?
Yeah, yeah.
You put him in there because, you know, he's like all the women they like. All the women they like to look at Jeremy. And maybe some men too would like to look at Jeremy. But Jeremy would say what words he was used. But see, as you can hear, like here, I think he's set in the circle already.
Right,
and then he was saying... let's do the Tua is very accurate, you know.
Yeah,
and then
somebody said,
no, the circle one. Somebody would say no to Jeremy. Suggest
change that
and don't put accurate. Put that he is. How do you say the word? He's adequate.
Okay.
Now I understand why you got me confused. So that's right. Okay.
Sorry,
whatever good stuff that Jeremy is going to say, they're going to change the words, right?
That is right.
So that's what the circle is.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
I understand. Let's hear what Jeremy did then. Say it again. If some of you missed it, this is what he said.
A player-led voting process. The coach, Mike McDaniel, said the third-year quarterback was, quote, the resounding highest point winner. That feels significant when you consider the totality of the conversation around Tua during this offseason. Jeremy, what are we hearing?
Well, the Dolphins are going to air it out. They are not afraid to let Tua throw the deep ball. The previous Miami regime had some concerns about his limitations throwing the ball. The Dolphins with Mike McDaniel do not care. They believe Tyreek Hill and Tua have a major connection. You saw it in the preseason. You saw it in training camp practices. So he doesn't have a Josh Allen, Justin Herbert type arm, but they feel like he is
not
adequate throwing from all levels of the
field. Not adequate. That is what I mean.
Yeah, and so as you can see, so that's why they, you know, as you heard him say, Jeremy, you know, so basically you get together in a circle and, you know, you call a circle for Jeremy.
That is right.
A circle
and then
Jeremy.
You decide which word Jeremy is going to use.
Not
complimenting Tua. Well,
that
you can compliment, but use different words.
That is right.
So,
yeah.
That's what happens everywhere.
Yeah.
So when these haters go around, that's what they do.
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
You know, the clown saying that it's propaganda trying to say all the good things about Tua, you know. Is bull baloney.
I mean, really.
That is right. So anytime you want to hate on Tua,
you
call a circle Jeremy, you know, and then you decide which word to use, you know. I mean, this is what it is.
Okay. a circle Jeremy is that.
Okay. So that's the photo of a circle Jeremy. Yeah.
So whatever
good things you're going to say about Tua, you say you all put in the bad words.
That is the
negative words.
And
belittle Tua. Okay,
yeah.
I understand.
Yeah.
That is what the whole plan is, because that's the only way they can be uniform all around. You know, all the platforms from the old media, they all get together and do that. Yeah.
Yeah.
And they call a circle Jeremy just for that.
All right. So... now, for the game on Sunday, you know, here's the thing for the game on Sunday. They had a press conference already. And what he's not so sure, though, is
is that people were asking questions about Waddle.
And he's playing.
You know, last week, McDaniel said that very, very, very sure that...
That is right.
You know...
Waddle will play.
Waddle will play.
Yeah.
So because if they wanted to play last week, he would have played last week. But, you know, he's just holding him off until Sunday. But here's the what Tua said about that. I'll play it right here.
It was a good day to kind of help iron all of those things out. And if Mike does allow Jalen to play, then I think it's better for us that he does.
Yeah. So here's the, you know, we all... Before Mike McDaniel came over, we said that everybody said that he has the funniest press conference.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But in a good kind of way.
At the press
conference on Wednesday, that funny side showed. But he's also showed a side that he's very fair. Answers questions. He puts his thought into answering the questions.
Well, he's smart.
Which is not normal for most coaches.
That's true.
We see a different side of Mike McDaniel, and we know that his press conferences are always, well, it's real. You know, he doesn't put on a show. It just happens that way.
Yeah.
So, you know, everybody was fighting to ask questions yesterday for Mike McDaniel, but here you can actually hear what he said about question about Tua and Jalen Waddle because they haven't been playing for a while. But
yeah.
Here's what I mean when he drops, you know, when haters out there always look for the negative side. In this case, it's Mike McDaniel is always looking for positive stuff.
And
you know, so when you ask about Waddle, he's going to answer honestly. But here's the thing about Waddle that none of the talking heads who hate him ever says. And that is they never talk about Waddle and Tua Tagovailoa throwing to him to be able to break the rookie record for most receiving.
That is right.
And I mean, no one ever says anything because they want to keep that hidden from everybody.
Yeah.
But this is, Mike McDaniel doesn't care. He tells everybody the truth.
That is right.
And he's funny without knowing he's funny. Here he is. And by the way, he did answer the question about Waddle, if he's playing. And he did say that very, very, very. But you got to listen because it's funny.
Mike, what do you see on film when you watch
movies? I have to. I can't. Three times now I'm the bad guy.
Thank you, Mike. We saw Tua and Tyreek work on a limited basis during the preseason together. Jalen did not play during the preseason. If he's ready to go, as you anticipate, what do you hope that connection will be with Tua and Jalen under game-like conditions as the season starts?
Well, ironically, that I think that's the highest comfort level that Tua's had in his NFL career. You know, when you're contributing to an NFL record amount of rookie receptions, and I noticed it when I was evaluating to this offseason, how convicted and how confident he played when throwing the ball to Jalen specifically. So that I don't see any I mean, he went into the whole process with the most comfort level with him to start, and he's been gaining a ton of confidence and comfort with our other receivers, and they've been catching up to Jalen really. So I have no worries about it. Excited to see him play, and really see all of our guys play together, because we haven't got to do that besides in Miami Gardens practice fields.
Expect Jalen to go this week then.
What did I say last week? Very, very.
Three varies.
I mean, he is limited.
Yeah.
But my confidence hasn't changed.
From the in the back. Oh, did I just jump?
This is survival of the fittest.
What do you see when you watch Mac Jones?
Well, anyway, as you can hear, it's very funny to be in one of his press conferences. But as you heard from him saying that, Waddle will be there to play, but as he said later that he'll be limited, so he's in, you know. And and another thing that I thought was interesting was now I'm talking about Tua. Tua, we'll jump over to Tua because
later Tua had a press conference, and then one of the questions they asked him was basically what everybody was talking about this week about captaincy, you know. And really, I mean, last year they made such a big deal that he didn't make captain, and this year when he made it, they still made a big deal out of it. But this is what Tua's answer to that.
Yeah, well, I would say it doesn't change the way I lead. You know, I'm very grateful that my teammates think very highly of me in that way. You know, and I think the coolest thing is no one needs to go up and give a speech and tell the team why you should vote for me as a captain. You know, it's cool that coach just allows the guys to decide. And, you know, coach may say that I had the most votes, but there's a lot of guys that, you know, have a lot of respect in our locker room that the guys really trust and, you know, really want to play for. So, you know, I'm very, you know, grateful about that. But it doesn't change the way that I go about my business or how I lead or how I talk to the guys.
That is right, yeah. So, yeah, it was a big deal last year about captaincy and this year also. But as you can see, you know, it's very simple. You know, you have a coach that trusts Tua and everybody believes in. And they look, like you said, you don't have to campaign to be a leader. Everybody just pick you.
That's
and
right.
They realize that Tua has done all the right things, you know, all along. So picking Tua was just natural for everybody.
Yeah.
And let's hear a last question about Tua being 3-0 against Belichick.
Oh,
this was kind of a nice question.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, for us, we put the last question, but you guys can go and over to Miami Dolphins YouTube channel, and the whole interview is in there, because we're running out of time here. So here's the last one from Tua.
And I love his answer, because it's never about Tua. You know, he's 3-0 because not of Tua. He's 3-0 because of the team.
And I love the fact that Tua is able to answer questions like that. You know, it's always about the team, and this is what he said.
Enabled you guys to have so much success against the Patriots, you being 3-0 specifically?
Well, I mean, I wouldn't attest that, you know, I'm 3-0. I would attest that we're 3-0 as a team. Takes all of us. You know, I'm just the distributor. I, you know, just got to get it to our playmakers. They make the plays, and our defense gets us the ball back, and our defense makes stops. Special teams, they do their part, and, you know, that's how you win games in this league.
Yeah. So with that, you know, we'll go continue. And as we said before, this is our third time we're doing this content here. It took a long time, and we erase. But anyway, now that we are here, so some of the content is all different. All three of them are different. This is different from the other one. But some of the things that we're trying to keep the same is basically we had this thing about Tua and Tyreek, and then it came to the idea that, like he just mentioned in his press conference, it's about the whole team. He's just a distributor, and because of that, we got this picture over here of the real cheaters, or Real. We call them Real because Spanish word for royal.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
Like Real Madrid or something like that.
Yeah,
and. Here it is, of the
that is right.
Real cheaters.
Yeah, and then you have Tua is the distributor, and they have Cedric Wilson Jr., Trent Sheffield, then you have Raheem Mostert,
then you have Waddle, then you have Tyreek. And Tyreek is wearing a crown.
Oh, yes, I like
you
that,
know,
man.
A purple crown as the royal cheaters.
Very kingly, you know?
Very kingly. King of the Cheetahs. Yeah, that is Tyreek Hill. And as you can see, we just put the first name for Tua, Waddle, and Tyreek. And I know because the other three there, well, and Tyreek is very popular, but the other three, we made sure that we put all the names because they're new in the team, just like Tyreek, but we all know Tyreek. And we have another, and we thought that we could have like a challenge, like... how do you call it? Because basically the question that was asked about why is Tua 3-0, we got this idea because we saw like how some people like these two here, they put up this chart about how Belichick has lost twice since 2013. Miami Dolphins since they've been in Miami. And we kept saying, why aren't they doing the real thing and say that Tua is 3-0? But nobody wants to give Tua credit.
No,
that's the thing. It's the denial. You know, it's never saying that Tua is good enough. And if Tua is 3-0 and he says the whole team is playing, no one is going to mention that.
Yeah.
No one is going to mention that he broke the record, helped break the record with Jalen Waddle. For the rookie reception record. Yeah,
doesn't fit the
no
the
one
narrative,
is gonna mention
negative
so
narrative.
We put up this chart over here. Let's hold it, see.
Yeah. There it is.
And here it is. Look. So there is the record with what they put up. And we decided to put it as win. So there it is. But here's what we wanted everybody to see.
Yeah, yeah.
This
so
one. That's Tua it. Versus Belichick. He is 3-0.
Oh, it looks better. Looks
and
better.
Mac versus Tua. that is 0-2.
Yeah.
That looks even better. But no one is gonna do that.
No.
We do it here to make it easier for everybody.
Yeah.
You know, we recognize it. We are not in denial. We are just saying that this is gonna be a good game. And then, you know, we thought, okay, so what's the deal here with the games? As you look at the record here shows that there's a 2019. When the Miami lost, when we lost to the Patriots in 2019, it was 43-0. Now, I put this list up yesterday on the community
page.
if you want to go into the community page, and look at the picture and just click on it, thumbs up, or if
we're
going to
put
another picture, because we are going to put a poll up and see who's going to win the game. So
that is right.
One of my scores that I wanted to put up there was 43-0. If the Dolphin can give back.
Yeah, payback is
can,
that is right.
Can make sure that they beat them by 43-0. It's possible.
A good defense.
You know, last against Philadelphia, it was 48-10.
Yeah.
So it's possible for them to score that high.
Yeah.
But now you will have Tyreek and also with Waddle.
Yeah,
so we'll see what happens. I'm sure they can get up that high.
Yeah, that is right.
And you will make a poll of who's going to win, right? From our last content, we talk about, we had Planet Killer say something about cheetahs.
That's right.
And then we thought, okay, what if we use this picture here? Yes, the real cheetahs, not cheetahs, C-H-E-E-T-A-H, but cheaters, C-H-E-A-T-E-R-S.
That is right.
So this is funny.
Who is going to win?
Yeah.
The real cheetahs?
Yeah.
The real cheetahs or the real cheetahs?
Okay, so please go to community page because you cannot go on with your mobile. I think if you have desktop, you can get into the community page
and vote.
That'll be very nice if you vote. We'll have picture of this, but it's better if you just vote and we'll count it next time.
Yeah, yeah.
So
that'll
please,
be cool.
And also put your scores. What do you think the score will be this coming weekend? On your comment. Just comment and say what the score will be, and then we'll count it. And thank you very much. I'm sorry we couldn't read any of your comments, but shout out to all of you who commented. We read everything, and we had it in the first two episodes here that we erased. But now we just run out of time, and we'll try to put comments on the next time. And thank you so much for all your support and people that joined our channel here. Thank you very much. Looking forward for the game on Sunday. And as always, take care and be safe out there, everybody.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah, Tua Tagovailoa. Tua Tagovailoa. Ibua. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah.
Well, Tua is one of the most accurate quarterbacks in the NFL, man. So,
I mean, obviously, you know, Tua, he's not your typical gunslinger, but, you know, like, if you really, like, just pay attention to his game, you know, everything is spot on, everything is pinpoint. You know, ball is on time. You know, his fundamentals are on point.
The NBA has most improved player. I think the NFL should have that. And if the NFL had that, Tua would be in line for that, don't you think?
Hey, go on, Tua. Come on now, Tua.
Well, Tua's just sitting down there with his ukulele in Miami. This is the first time he's been told that he's the starter. And Chris Long's like, well, nobody's going to be able to.